Hello everyone, this is Ender Tyron. We're back with Epic Flail episode 27. Taking my Israeli deck out for the third time. Let's see if I can get a competent opponent so I can really put this deck to the test. You know, I want to fight someone who's actually better at the game than me, you know, like I normally do. And hopefully, when that happens, I'll finally be able to, you know, really see what this deck, my Israel general deck, is capable of. At least that's my hope. Of course, that requires me to get into a battle first. Which, you know, can sometimes take a while. Though I suppose if I get too bored, I can just turn on War Chat and see what's happening there. Oof. Yep. Wrong button. Where is it? Yeah, I changed up my... I didn't point this out in episode 26, but... I changed my Rove 90 from being in the Nagmakan to being in the Axarit. Or Axarit, however that's supposed to be pronounced. There's probably more sound in there than I'm giving it, but I don't speak Hebrew, so I'm not quite sure how exactly everything's supposed to be pronounced. Anyway. Let's see. Anything else? Yeah, I think that's about all. What are the Marines called again? Right, the Givati. They only have the RPG 7V, which is... It's not bad. It's just not the greatest. Anyway. I think I might redo some of this. You know, probably drop the Yasser Nimrod and give the Maoglan a different transport, probably like the Ram Reki. And I guess I'll have to play it out a bit more, see how everything pans out with the guys in the Nimrod. I only have four of them, so, and it's 120 points to call them out, so yeah, definitely need to be cautious with how I deploy them. Tanks, tankety tanks. Nothing's changed here. Support. Nothing's changed here either. Cat is meowing. Yeah, nothing here. And no change here. How does this compare to the 1400 pound bomb, or 1400 kilogram bomb, I should say. So 25 points. What else? So the Lavi is faster than the Kafir, has better ECM, has better air detection. It does have a couple of SRAMs, not great SRAMs, 50% accuracy and pretty standard range and accuracy for SRAMs, only for HE, so definitely not going to deter any ASFs from trying to mess with it. And yeah, that's about it. Got my seed. Got a Lavi and a Nesser. I like rocket planes. Rocket planes are fun. Don't use them very often though. I find that they're good if you want to eliminate like a single unit. Like with that was one of my favorite things to do with the Canadian CF-104 Starfighter, is because its rocket pods have scroll down, there we go. Its rockets have better range and accuracy compared to basically all the other similar size rockets. And should definitely make some very good at, you know, sniping exposed anti-air units. Especially if you send this out with an electric voodoo. You can definitely, if you're like a Soviet player or whatever, has their fancy 100-point Tunguska M out on them somewhere, and you have good eyes on it, you can just snipe it with your Starfire. Of course, that does require you have line of, you know, requires that you have a line of sight on it, so you can actually reliably kill it. But yeah, there's something you can do. What else can I talk about? I can't think of anything. I don't know. What deck should I do after Israel? Like, these are all my 1v1 decks that I have made so far. You've seen these ones already. I haven't used the 1v1 USSR. Looks like something needs to be done there. Is that, what, plane tab get shifted or something? Whatever, this need to rework this a bit. Looks like I'm heavily dependent on Ve De Ve. And what else do I want? I have a blue dragon deck. That could be fun. Got the Dutch-German armored. I've used that one before. Swedish, there we go. Bring North Korea. Right, that could end well. NORAD, I don't know. What does my 1v1 NORAD look like right now? I think I built this on during a video. Oh, I opened the wrong one. Oops, I'm good at this. Let's see. Lots of smalls. They did get nerfed. Price nerf, I should say. Cane rifles. Yeah, TH-495 got its armor buffed. Or, it used to have two all around, and now it has three front and side and one on the back and top, so I guess you could say it's an overall buff to its armor. Pretty sure all the numbers add up to the same amount. But anyway, it's now 20 points, so it does make Canadian rifles a little bit more expensive to deploy. So yeah, I should probably look through and reorganize this tab. Especially now that basically, Canadian rifles are, basically, they used to be one of the better line infantry just because the C6 or and all the other FN Meg variants were pretty, they're above average machine gun, if I recall correctly, so all the units that using them were above average in terms of anti-infantry, but since machine guns are now all standardized for the most part, so riflemen could be something to bring. Especially bring them in maybe one of the better Bradleys. Except they nerfed the optics on the Bradley for whatever reason. Let me show you. Nope. Not on that one, is on these ones here. They nerfed them, I'm sure they have their reason for it. See, 3-3, and this one is 5 on the front, 4 on the side. So yeah, this one can definitely take a hit now. What else? I don't know. Support. Almost all Canadian. Obviously, I should be bringing the Patriot. Thing's terrible. Anyway, what else? Tank. Pretty standard, I guess. Recon. Got the longbow. I've never actually used the longbow. Because I don't play US and NORAD very often, so yeah, I've never really had an opportunity to see how cheesy I can be with it. But anyway, moving on. M3A2, that's always a fun one to use. Nothing like a ATGM carrier that actually has some degree of stealth. Rangers. These guys are all right. I have 25 scout and not that good, but it's a cheap wheeled recon that I can throw about. Oh, gone into a battle. All right, here we go. Only had to wait 10 minutes. All right, and we're on Punjing Valley. I'm facing Russian Fear. Why should I say like a rush with Russian? It's Russian Fear. You would be scared of me. I'm terrifying. Anyway, I think I should really invest in some command infantry, apparently. Anyway, where do I want to drop this? I just put it there for now, or there. Anyway. Let's leave that guy there for base defense. Send this one up to Alpha for Foxtrot. Send a pair of these guys and one of those guys. Same for Bravo. Send a pair of these guys and one of these guys. And they can also get a pair of these guys. And for recon, they get some Bedouins. Alright, now for the middle. Let's bring one of those. Let's bring that. Yep, summon a tree. Okay. I guess I can go for one of those as well. I'll drop that for now. Okay, let's just bring one of those. I need my infantry. There's that. There's that. That's not what I wanted to click on. There we go. And what else do I want to bring? I guess I should bring proper air defense. There we go. And I guess that will do. And I guess I shall see how this goes. Okay, moving that up. Alright, he's got wheels into there, I'm guessing. Oh, looks like you went for a 3-command start. Alright. Got. Looks like it's. Something. Not too sure. Guessing he's. I saw Humvees in there, or some Humvee variant, if I can get the right button. Yep. So, oh, is he doing a. Mech General. Alright, let's get that off the road. Those guys are not going to be in for a good time. There's his command. Damn it, that's not gonna go well. Let's unload that. Nope, I wasn't paying attention. These guys are out in the open. I think I lost my Mac bet. Yep, it's dead. Forgot to unload these guys. I'm good at this. Alrighty. This looks like it's going to be delightful. Let's keep pushing, I guess. Alright, I want to get some variety of cap going. Yep. Because otherwise that happens. So nets. No, can't remember. Okay, we got Magland in the open. I don't have anything to stop him with right now. Another Nets, is that like a napalm bomber or something? Nope, cluster bomber. Oh, that hurts. Oh wait, I know how to deal with that. Let's not get too close, because that happens. I completely forgot to unload these guys. I'm brilliant. Alright. Getting pressed on all sides. I'm at a 1-point disadvantage. What do I want to do? Get Bedouins out over here. I said Bedouins out over there. There we go. Oh, fuck. That's not going down well. Yep, I'm screwed. Oh, it's a trade. Recon. Get one of those in the mid. Over there. Infantry. Some of that. Those guys are dead. Alright, here we go. Okay. Need to do something about the point bleed. we got something there. Get in the damn building. Helicopter. I lost my sight. That's a gazelle cannon. Finally. I should have just brought up my rocket plane for that. Alright, Macbeth's out. Another cannon? Looks like it. Apparently they lost line of sight. No, no range. Let's get my last ASF out. That okay. Let's get out of there before I have hornet problems and stingers, I'm guessing. Looks like a pain train of bombs. Okay. Stallies on the road. I need more infantry over there. Yeah, figures. Kings H7 is delightful. Hello. SSR in the back, lovely. Come on, come on, do your building work. And of course they're invincible. There we go. Alright. I'm floating a lot of points right now, and I don't want to. That. All right. Appears to be helicopters. Thanks, H7s. Nope, not enough range. Anyway. CF-188 still hovering about. There we go. Alright, Maglan. Lovely. There we go, those guys. I'm floating points again. Let's get those out again. Those guys should not be out in the open. Get some board. Not a Yonshiki E, lovely. Got to turn the weapons off on those guys, so they're dead, very dead. Let's try for try to keep that guy relatively close to the front while not being in, you know, within range of, you know, enemy air defense. He's got a lot of stuff in there. Looks short range, probably infrared man pads, I'm guessing. Those, I saw he had a bunch of stingers. Probably brought them out in Bradley's, I'm guessing. Anyway. What was I saying? Or was I doing more appropriately? Need more recon. And more of these guys. Don't know why I just let that guy sit in there. Not a one shot, but I guess it will suffice for now. And of course it blew up my supply truck. And that gets side-shotted. He's dead. Very dead. I'm terrible with super heavies, especially when I don't pay attention to what I'm doing with them. Or what I'm doing with them. Should have brought out a mortar. H1Js, that's not fun. Yeah, that's a lot of not fun stuff there. That's flying way too close to the enemy air vents. Oh, Oh, I completely forgot to unload those guys, so they're very dead now. Currently that guy has no line of sight whatsoever. Let's say Nana Yanshiki, of course. Come on. Do your magic LRM thing. There we go. I keep forgetting to actually spend my points. Lots of ATGMs. Happy, happy, fun, fun ATGMs. That got blowed up. What'd it get stunned by? Or no, it's these guys who are stunned. That guy's just panicked from the rockets. That is no way of attacking them. No AA left there. Okay. What to do? Of course, scout leopards. I should discourage it for a bit. Okay, there's that. Dead. Oh, tired. This shouldn't be too much longer. I have no eyes here, so that recon leopard can pretty easily sneak up on my guys. Unless I can do that. I guess some recon spotting me there. Yeah, Maglan again. Gimbal's not gonna last much longer. Dead. That's out of bombs. I need to remember to actually spend my points. And that's game. Alright, so I did pretty bad in that battle. I lost 500 conquest points to 0, 1,040 kills to 2,765 losses. So what cost me in that battle? I say I lost the initiative in my opening. I did not handle my opening forces well at all, and that put me on the back foot for basically the entire battle. And this is also a demonstration of just, simply thanks to Israel that, Blue Ford is, back in business by the looks of it. I'm not sure what it is. I think it's probably Blue Mech, I'm guessing. Or no, it wouldn't be Blue Mech because he has Stollies. It could just be Blue General or maybe even Blue Motorized. Yeah, I think this was actually, might have been a motorized deck. I'd have to look it up, but that's whatever. Alright, yep, so definitely something to think about. And I also saw my opponent using making proper use of those maglands. They said in the right hands, aka not mine there. They can be pretty potent. I think I'm gonna call it quits here with Israel. I think it's an alright deck, I'm just not overly fond of it. I'll find something else I can mess around with. Anyway, I'm Xander Chiron, and this was Epic Flail Episode 27. You guys have a lovely day.